welcome to Elvenhome and to this video, which, as I described in the previous one, I'd originally intended most of this material to be part of the previous video, but it would have made it much too long. I mean, as you'll see, this video is about 25 minutes long, including heavily speeded up sections. And I will put in the description for this video the timings in case you want to fast forward to when you get past just watching me build the canopy in particular, which I'll show you how I go about doing it. But the whole video is about an hour it took me to do it, and I've speeded it up quite a bit. But there's quite a balance between speeding it up so fast that the time doesn't take too long to pass by, but equally you can see what it is that I'm doing. And then the section where I actually build how I went about building the platform buildings, which are all made out of card. I also thought it was about time that you saw a bit more of me. You'd have seen me, I think, in the second video when I was building the baseboards, but I was buzzing around then quite fast. And if Everard Junction and Simon Shed can go on camera, I don't see why I can't either. So straight into the video now, and you'll see the completed station back on the platform as you've seen it before. And I hope you enjoy this video of the building. I had great fun building the canopies and working out how to scratch build the platform buildings. And it's given me precisely what I want, so I'm very pleased with the outcome. But enjoy the video, and maybe I'll speak to you again on camera in the next video too, if you're very unlucky. Okay, speak to you later. Hello and welcome to this section, which is essentially filming me making the bays for the station and also the final station buildings, or at least part of that, just to give you an idea of how it is that I put them together. This is the parcels office on the station, which is the left hand side of the second group of buildings on the station. You can say the first 16 bays of the station have been built, together with the building you've already seen me build a couple of videos ago. This is the one I was talking about a little bit earlier. And then you've got the four bays at the end, which just need their roofs attached, which I've now decided are going to be empty. And what I'm about to do is to build the final four bays and start setting out the main building. For those final four bays, which will include principally a waiting room with one small office. I'm not sure I've yet given a station master his office, so we'll give him an office on the platform. So on the table, if I bring you up a little, are the constituent parts of the kit from Metcalf. See if I can go back out now, out fully there. Those of you that have done Metcalf kits will be familiar with the ridge tiles. In fact, I'm not using them because as you bend the ridge tile, you have a piece of white card that appears, which needs to be painted in, which is fine. But looking at the ridges on the roof, there is no white section, and I think they look fine as they are myself. But if I change my mind, I can always put those ridges back on. The next piece of card are largely formers, including a little jig to help me put together the stanchions that form the canopy. We have quite thick card, which is the card for the canopy. This grey card here contains the roof parts of varying kinds. And the main part of the kit, which you can see here, let me just do this together. This is wood, this is a very thin wood, which has the pieces on it that form the stanchions. What these essentially make, these T parts here, is, I have one here, is one of these. And the detail on these is absolutely brilliant. I'm so pleased with this kit. But I thought I'd show you how you put one of these things together, which I will do in speeded up form. Do not fear, you have not got hours of watching me laboriously go through sticking all this together. Just to add the bits on. So when I come back, this will be running faster as I build the kit. See you in a minute. To kick off, one thing I'd forgotten entirely is that with the kit you have five of these stanchions, because of course you need five to be able to get four bays. And because I've been building kits with Guy Abandon, I actually have all the stanchions I need from previous kits where I've not used them. This one needs to have at the bottom here, if I bring it into the camera, there we go, that needs to be painted black like those ones have, just to give the bottom jump I'll do in a moment. But that does mean this building is going to be a little bit easier, because by far the major part in terms of complexity is putting together these kits, which you use this little jig for. These are made up in three layers. There are two, there's one fairly plain one which has the in the center has the design on it, which you can probably see there if I get this right. Must remember to work back to front. And that has either side the pieces that have the slots that will take the cross members that go in, as you'll see when we start putting it together. So what I'm going to do now is just very quickly paint that last one, and then we can start putting it together. And as I said, from this point on, I probably won't say very much, or I won't say anything, because I'm going to speed this up so that you don't have to sit for hours watching what's going on. So I'll come back when we have the next four bays built. Okay, what I was trying to show earlier, if I can get this the right way around, gosh it's weird working back to front, is that these stanchions fit into little slots that are here. As you, if I put that in, you can see how it starts to form the canopy with one inch side, and then the roof goes over the top. And that's the bit that I'm going to be doing shortly. that's all the building of the main canopy done. The only thing that's left to go on are the roof parts, but they won't go on until I've built the building that's going to go into this forebay here. And in order to build that, I don't want to put on the last roof piece. I've discovered if I put that on, it gets in the way. So what I'll do now is I'll close this section down, and when we come back, I'll have the pieces out that form the walls for the building. Hello and welcome back. In this section I'm going to just take you through the approach that I've made to the building of the building station buildings on the island platform. I hadn't originally intended to scratch build them. I had intended that the buildings on there would have been another of the Metcalfe's kits, which you, those of you who've seen the Metcalfe kits will have seen their platform buildings, but they took the opportunity to upgrade them, and so they weren't available. And in the meantime, I came across the canopy, which you've just seen me building, which are just so beautiful. And I wanted to find a way of inserting something within, under the canopy that gave me the buildings. And that's where the idea came of scratch building my own buildings and taking the approach of a clapboard construction for the main buildings, because it is an island platform. It's unlikely to have had big, heavy brick buildings on such a platform, and the clapboard seems to work really quite well. What you see before you are the drawings that I did for the centre building, the one that was at the start of this section, which has the parcel office and the lavatories. And what you can see here, this is the front part, which is the bit that you as you can see on the building, and this is the bit at the back which I haven't shown you, which is largely wall except for high level windows which give light into the two lavatories, and I will give you a view of both sides of the station before it goes on. The far side of the station, of course, is rarely going to be seen because it faces the what will be a wall, which is a retaining wall for the embankment that's taken the line up to High Elven. The thing that I'm going to be building next is the waiting room, which is the final building that goes right at the end of the platform. And in a way, this is fairly straightforward to build because I'm intending to build two walls. The basic construction is that the right and left-hand walls are built, the walls facing the platform edges for platform 2 and 3. Are built as separate pieces, and then they're joined by end walls to the left and right, which pull together the two outer walls with a tab that clicks in, and I'll show you that as I go through. I'm not going to do this as a speeded up section. I'll be doing it in sections, so I'll cut pieces out, you'll see what it looks like, and then I may do the constructing the building itself. It takes quite some preparation because I have to carefully measure once I've cut out the end walls, which have got to be precisely done so they fit within the legs of the canopy. And although in general terms obviously the distances are broadly the same, there are fine differences because as you've built each of the legs, they're not all absolutely the same distance apart, so it takes a bit of fiddling to get it to go as you want. But for the waiting room, what my intention is that there will be a door on the left hand side followed by 6 windows, and these lines down here mark the stanchions coming down from the canopy roof, and this sits under and inside the building. I think I've shown you before that the walls are simply, and really are no more, than this, which is a Word document. It's a table. It's simply a one-column table with many rows in it, I think at 5-point font size. And I played around with the colours, the fill colour, until I got the kind of cream colour that was quite common, and then the red band is the bottom half of the inner wall, with the cream being the upper half. And essentially this top half that you can see here is the outer wall and the inner wall. And I cut this to the length that I need for the wall, fold it along the centre line, and then stick windows and things in between, as you'll see as I go along. So all the walls that are in the model are essentially double thickness, and give me a proper interior and exterior. There's one or two places, and that means that some of the doors, particularly if there's windows coming through from the other side, have had to be built so that they are, they're not just white card on the other side. The only exception to that was that the lavatory doors in the centre building cannot be seen. The windows at the back are high up. So they were fairly easy. They were just doors from another Metcalf kit. And most of what I've been using has been remnants from other Metcalf kits that I've made, which was rather handy. So these buildings have cost me very little. The main cost has been a series of stickers, which are what have been used for putting timetables and platform numbers and that kind of thing up and onto the buildings. The one area where I did have to invest in a bit of expense was to get some scale seams doors, LNER colours, because I'd found myself increasingly using green and cream. Now, as I'm not down the southern region, the only other place where that does is LNER, and I realised that that's roughly where the layout is set. Hence that you may have seen some of the things that the LNER appears. It's amazing how the layout is evolving in my mind as I'm building it. One of the problems I had, however, is that these doors, as you can see, there are a range of doors and windows of different kinds. This is printed on medium density card. I can't remember what it is, about 200, maybe a bit less. To provide the cutouts, but the doors I discovered were slightly smaller than the doors used on Metcalf kits, and the solution I eventually realised was to change the scale at which they were printed out. So instead of printing them out, that's printing out at 100%, and so I printed them out then, and a bit by trial and error, and I think this is something like 125%. And if I can try and show you, I'm not sure I can actually put the two together on the page. Oh, there you are. You get some idea that they're just slightly bigger, but it gives the right size. So doors where I need them, as I shall be using them, the waiting room doors are going to be these ones here. And you may not quite be able to see, but although there are two doors side by side, rather handily, if you fold them down the middle, one gives the back to the other, so that will work perfectly with some acetate in between to provide the windows. So that's going to be the doors. Windows is fairly straightforward. You just cut out the hole, and I have loads, as I suspect many of you have, of these windows left over from other Metcalf models. And I need 12 windows because there's going to be two. The doors will be in the first of the four bays, and then there'll be two windows in each of the next three bays. And I'll be using this kind of window for the waiting room. And rather handily, I'm going to have doors at opposite ends of the building so that when a train comes in, people don't have to head to the same end of the room if two trains come in on either side of the island platform. So the door facing platform two will be on the left of the building, and then on the opposite corner will be the door to take people out onto platform three. But that means that each wall is exactly the same, so I don't have to build an inner inch with everything turned round on it, which makes life a lot more straightforward, because there's a lot of quite precise measuring. And rather handily for me, many years ago, for a different hobby, I got hold of one of those, which is a vernier caliper, and it has been invaluable because I am really measuring to the nearest millimetre. and being able to measure accurately with this thing has meant that things have fitted. So that's a bit of a description. What I'm going to do now is go away and cut out the walls for the waiting room, and I'll come back once I've done that so you can see the walls before I start trying to assemble things. Hello and welcome back. It's now probably a couple of hours later than the previous section. And in that time, I've been busy measuring out and cutting out all the bits that will be needed for the building. On the far left, which you can just about see, I'm trying to get a reflection, are the windows waiting to be stuck in. These are the door sections, which I showed you before, which have been cut out, and the windows sections removed. A piece of clear perspex will go in the center. And that folds across to give me the both sides of the doors, because I'll be able to see in from the back of the building. This is an end wall for the building, which just simply wraps around the tabs that I've cut into the main wall. And now you can see that that folds over there to give you the outer wall, and there's the inner wall. Those are the tabs at the end over which the end wall sits. And that gives me my end wall. So the only thing I've got to do now is to put this all together and to get it to fit. You'll see that I've cut slots here. That's so when this goes into the bays, the walls sit in the right place. So they will sit, they will eventually, there you go. They sit level with the stanchions, with the legs, to give me a nice even bottom, if you see what I mean. Okay, right, what I'm going to do now is try and put all this together, and I'll come back once I've actually put it together and fitted it into the bays. Otherwise this will go on forever. See you in a moment. Welcome back. Here you can see the building inserted into the canopy. It's the two end walls, the tabs are inserted into the end walls, they've closed over to give me the rectangle. You can see the door, the waiting room door is now in, and I've put some of the stickers that I was mentioning, so the station name, Weathertop, waiting room on the door, a platform number. And as I move along the building, you can see that it sits in quite nicely in between the legs. You'll notice actually that the windows are different. I ever so slightly slipped up by cutting the holes too big, which was not very wise. As it happened, I was quite annoyed about that until I took a look at the windows that I was going to put in, and they just look wrong because they are sash windows from a building, from a house. Whereas if you look at station waiting rooms and windows, they're much bigger. So quite by chance, I cut the hole the right size, and of course all that then needs is clear perspex inside, and I think they look quite fine. And you can, I can't zoom in anymore, but you can see through the window that the interior wall is showing from the other side. So that really works quite well. I was quite pleased with that. So that's the whole thing in the end. That's the final part of the canopy. And as I promised to give you a look at the other side of the buildings, this is the central one, which has, and you can see there that there are two or four windows that are quite high up. If you N-gauge figures are very small, and those are comfortably above head height. You'd have to be on somebody's shoulders to look in there. But those windows are going in, are looking into the back of the gents' lavatories on the left and the ladies' lavatories on the right. There's some posters and things on the back of the wall that is the parcels office, so that's all set up there. And then if I come around further, you reach the first building that I built, which is there's no doors on that side at all. That's the back of the buffet, and at the far end that's the back of the office. So that's essentially the building of the building. I'll come back in just a moment with it back on the layout where you've seen it before, just to round off this video. So I'll speak to you in just a moment. Well, here we are with it back on the layout, which is the safest place for it because being 20 bays long and the wood is really quite thin, you have to be very careful moving it around. Even the buildings going in there have probably strengthened it. I think if it was 20 bays long without any buildings in there, you would have trouble keeping it together. You'd have to reinforce it somehow. But here it is back on the layout again. Let's go in a bit further. So you've got the stairs where they come up from the building that would be facing it. As I've mentioned, the four empty bays, that's the buffet. Then in this section, which I forgot to mention in the previous video, that's where the ramp will also come up. So in between the legs of the canopy there will be a ramp coming up with more of that fencing going round. I've got to measure all that and put it in. Then we've got the parcels office and the lavatories, and finally the section that you saw me put on. One thing I forgot to mention in just the immediate previous section, you'll probably see if I go in a bit closer, the green strip at the bottom of the card. That's the normal kind of styrofoam strips that you get. I'm trying to see if I've got one here. There we go. It's the Evergreen Scale Models Strip Styrene, the 0.25 by 2.5 millimetres, yes, that's right, which is painted green, and it made a huge difference just putting that strip on at the bottom as essentially a skirting board. And you do see that with the clapboard buildings, they need to finish off the bottom where the board is overlapping. The bottom board needs reinforcing to stop it all splintering away. So that makes it's little details I'm discovering as I go on this journey that make all the difference when you start doing these sorts of things. And I was amazed how much difference it made in finishing off the building before it went down onto the platform. So in terms of completing the platform, among the many things which I kept telling you about over and over again last time is actually to do the platform, to get everything finely positioned and stuck down, to get the lamps on, to get the running in boards done, the ramp cut, and indeed the board itself positioned and fixed down, because it has to be very finely, the platform, very finely balanced to allow trains to pass properly either side, which they do at the moment, and hopefully they will do when I've got everything finished. So that's pretty much it for this video, which was very much about the building of it. As you'll see, it's probably about 24, 25 minutes long in total, the video, even with the speeded up sections. I hope you've enjoyed seeing how I made the station canopy and the buildings. And as I said, there'll be another update towards the end of April. One thing I didn't mention in the last video, which I'll mention now, is that one of the reasons I want to be where I am by the end of May is that in June, Nunney Castle is due to be released by Graham Farish, which, as some of you may know, is the first N-gauge steam engine with sound, which I've seen being demonstrated at the International N-Gauge show last year, and I'm really looking forward to being able to run it round the whole of this layout at some speed with the sound at full pelt, and you will be among the first to see that happen, I promise you. Okay, so thanks very much for watching. Please like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this, and I look forward to speaking to you again towards the end of the month. Bye bye.